Hi everyone, Shabbat Shalom Uvorach. We are introduced this week to our founding father and the father really of all of monotheism, Avraham Avinu. And God says to Avraham, Lech Lecha, leave. Leave your country, leave your father's house, and I'm going to make you rich. I'm going to give you fame. I'm going to give you children. I'm going to give you everything. And then God says, Va'avarecha mevarechecha. I'm going to bless those who bless you. Umkallelcha aor. And I'm going to curse those who curse you. But what's very interesting, if you paid attention to the Hebrew, is that when it comes to the blessing, God sticks to the same word, to the same root, Baruch. Va'avarecha mevarechecha. But when it comes to curse, God switches the root. God says, Umkallelcha, those who curse you, aor. He switches to the word or, which is a synonym. But the question is, why didn't God stay with the original word? He should have said, Umkallelcha, akallel. And there's an amazing answer given by Rav Levi Yitzchak of Bardichev. You know, you think about it, Avraham was an Isha Chesed. He was a man of kindness. Why in the world would anybody curse a person like Avraham? Why would somebody curse a Ish Chesed, someone who's kind, someone who's giving? Who in the world would curse him? And the answer must be that if you're cursing Avraham Avinu, you must not know who Avraham is. There has to be a misunderstanding. It can't be that you're cursing a guy like Avraham. If you're cursing him, it has to be that you're in the dark of who he really is. And so that's what God says to Avraham. Mekalelcha, those who curse you, they're in the choshech, they're in the dark. And so you know what I'm going to do? God says, I'm going to aor. Not curse them per se, but I'm going to or, show them the light. I'm going to explain to them and educate them on who you really are. And then automatically, your biggest haters will turn into your biggest fans. And that is God's message to the Jewish people. Unfortunately, there will be people in our lives that will curse us. There will be haters. There will be people out there that hate Jews. And we scratch our heads and we wonder, how could it be that the world is not siding with us? We have such amazing values. We're all about gratitude and kindness and peace and humanity. What in the world is going on? How could it be? And the answer is, Mekalilcha, it's because they're in the dark. And our job is to aor, is to educate, is to show them lies, to explain to them what a real Jew is. Because I guarantee you that if we sat down for just 5 minutes, we could probably explain to someone what a real Jew is, what our values really are. The story is told of Acham Uvadia Yosef. Right after he got married to his wife Margalit, her sister, who wasn't able to make it to the wedding, came to visit her. And as she's sitting in this very humble apartment, she looks around and she realizes the poverty that her sister is living in. She realizes that there's no food anywhere. There's nothing to eat. She couldn't believe that her sister agreed to live this life. She got angry at her own father and she starts yelling at him in front of everybody. At her own dad. How could you let your daughter marry this irresponsible scholar who can't even provide for his family? There's no food in the fridge. What's she going to eat? She's going to eat the Gemara. She's going to eat the books. And she gets so angry, she stands up, she grabs the head covering off her sister's head, and she throws it on the floor. Finally, after she calms down, and everyone's shocked, a disrespect to the rabbi, disrespect to her father, and she finally sits down. Acham Uvadia, not raising his voice, not getting angry, he simply explained to her why his wife agreed to marry him, why he chose to live this lifestyle. The sister started crying. She started apologizing. She went down on her knees, ready to kiss the rabbi's hands just to apologize and to ask his forgiveness. She picks up the head covering. She puts it back on her sister's head. Unbelievable. And when she left, she gave her sister her blessings. And when she got home, the first thing she did was she enrolled her children straight into yeshiva, who were in public school at the time. She said, if one of my children could turn out like him, I would be happy. Mekalelcha aor. If someone's cursing you, it has to be there's a misunderstanding here. They don't know, they're in the dark. Your job, our job, is to show them the light, explain to them, to be the or lagoyim, to educate. And in that way, we will turn our haters into our fans. Shabbat shalom.